Hello, my friends. Welcome back to another episode of Market Watch Mondays. As always, I am your host at MikeMeUpp with two P's. Today's episode is going to be a little bit different, a little bit bittersweet for me. I just want to come out here and let everyone know that I'm actually going to stop making fantasy football content. I'm going to be moving on from the channel, just moving on from fantasy content in general. I'm not like leaving BDGE to go join someone else. I didn't get recruited for by any of the big companies, anything cool like that. I'm not that desirable. But I just wanted to come on and just holler at the people, everyone that has supported me till now. I just want to say thank you. I appreciate you. And just give people a little background as to kind of why I'm stepping away from the game. And if you guys follow me on Twitter, some of you might have seen this coming. I've been tweeting stuff about, how I've been feeling about making content in the space. And it's just not there for me anymore. Like, I'm just not as passionate as when I first started. And I think, a couple weeks ago, I put out a video with a mistake in it, and someone in the comments pointed it out. And at first, I was like, damn, it's like, how could you make that mistake? And then the next thing I thought of was like, hey, maybe you're just not in your head's not as much in the game anymore. I took the last few days to really think this over. And I spoke to my girlfriend. I spoke with Nick. I spoke with some other friends as well. And, I decided it was just much better for me to move on because I didn't want to put out subpar content, right? When I first got into the game, when I first got into content and the Godfather himself plucked me out of the abyss and said, hey, Mike, come make Dynasty content for me. I've lived, breathed fantasy football all day long, on weekends, on weekdays. Ask my girlfriend, man. I was always researching stats, looking at players. I just don't have that same passion for fantasy football anymore. It's grown a little weary on me. And content specifically, I tweeted out something a couple weeks ago, maybe a couple months ago, which I retweeted last week, is when I first started, right, I made content in order to make myself more accountable and better at the game, right? So I was making content as someone that played fantasy football. I wasn't someone that was making content just for the sake of making content. I think that's what kind of made my approach a little bit unique, a lot of my strategies a little bit unique, because I was playing the game. I was playing 20, 30, 40 leagues at a time. So I had a lot of data points and a lot of strategies that I could test out and see what worked and what didn't. And more these days, I don't have that same love for playing fantasy football anymore. So it's like I'm almost playing fantasy football just so I can stay relevant enough to make content for people. Because I truly believe that if you don't play fantasy football, you don't make great content because you don't know what works, right? If you're not a winning player, you don't really have any of the stuff, the juice that backs up any of your theories. And at the end of the day, you're just shouting in the air or shouting into the abyss or shouting on Twitter about some shit that doesn't matter, right? But for me, that was a key pillar of my content creation was I love playing the game every single week. I love, wheeling and dealing. I love making money playing fantasy football. And, I made, a decent amount playing fantasy football. But the other part of it is that monetary aspect is almost no longer there for me. If you guys follow me on Twitter, I'm very deep into NFTs and very deep into crypto. And it's very hard for me to find the financial motivation to keep playing fantasy football and keep making content when I can flip a JPEG and make 10x what I make in fantasy football in a year in a week, right? So the financial incentive is totally gone. And those of you guys that know me, very early on, I said, hey, one of the big reasons why I played fantasy football is because there was a monetary aspect to it. If you took the monetary aspect out of the game, I just wouldn't like the game as much. And that just speaks to how much of a fucking degen I am, honestly, more than anything. But that financial aspect is totally gone. And throughout the content side, I've never really made a dollar making content here, right? So every single dollar that I've ever made through Patreon, I've put back into BDGE. I've fed it back into BDGE. I've given it to Nick. We've used that to, pay people or get rent or whatever. Every single dollar from Patreon has gone back into BDGE. That was the arrangement that we had because I believe in the brand. And I still believe in the brand. I think BDGE is freaking awesome. And I think BDGE is going to dominate the space. But I don't want to be the guy that comes on here and gives you subpar analysis and subpar content when others on the team like Noah and Nick and Max and Animal – sorry, Max Animal, the same person, but Snacks, and all these guys are putting out fire content when I don't have my heart in the game anymore. So that's really what it's about for me. Like, I'm stepping back from the game. I'm stepping back from content. I'm stepping back. I'm probably going to step back from like all the analysis, like rankings, all that shit. I don't care about that anymore. I'm probably only going to do it for fun for my home leagues. I'll probably stay in a couple of leagues just for fun. If you guys are in leagues with me, I've cut a bunch this year already because I didn't want to play that much. It was just way too taxing. And like, the opportunity cost of time for me is just not worth it anymore. Right? Like, my time, all of my spare time, aside from working my full-time job and spending time with my girlfriend and like family and stuff like that, goes in NFTs, because like, it's just like it's a 24-hour gig that's nonstop all year round. And if you've been in the Patreon, like, you know that I'm in that like crypto chat like quite a bit, just like talking about stuff, bouncing ideas off people, and talking about cool projects. And that's just like taking up way too much of my time. Like, when I sit down at the table, I'm like, hey, I need to prepare a video for this week, right? And the Market Watch Monday video has typically been about strategy and analysis, and that stuff takes me a long time. So it's like, do I have the time to dedicate that many hours to anymore? No, I just don't. So with that being said, like, it's been a very, very fun ride for me, right? You know, I'm thankful to like everyone that's kind of like been involved with my process so far, specifically Nick, right? For being one, just like a good friend who I just literally met on the internet on YouTube, and then two, like taking a shot on me to help make content for the site. And I've been doing it for like 3 years now, almost. It seems wild, but like it's been a while for me making content in the space. And you know, I'm sad that it's coming to an end, but also like, when I made the decision, to be honest with you, I felt like a giant like weight had been lifted off my shoulders. Like making content used to be super fun for me, and I used to look forward to it every single week. I used to look forward like noodling and drawing shit down on my paper and just thinking of all these weird strategies and weird things. And now, like, for the past little while now, when I'm making content, it feels like a little bit like a chore. It's like a more of like a job to me, right? I know I have to make a video every single week. I know I have to put it out by X time. I know I have to put it, you know, put in the Dropbox by a certain time so the editors can get to it. And honestly, like, shout out to Sexy Pats, who's been editing my videos for a while now. Like, without him, I might have quit like a while ago, because like the editing part of it, I really didn't like even when I first started. So him coming on board and helping me with that, like, really, really helped me out. So thank you, Sexy Pats. Thank you, Jared. You're a lifesaver, and you kind of extended my short fantasy career, you know, even that much longer. But yeah, it's like, you know, it just became too much like a job for me. And like, I gained like even so much more like newfound respect for Nick, who's been doing it, you know, for a long time as his job, like, and doing it daily, not just weekly like me. Like, if I had to do it that long, I don't know, man. Like, I think I would have just lost the joy for it a long time ago. But you know, and then obviously I want to thank like all the supporters, right? Anyone that's ever like watched one of my videos, put a comment, even if it's a negative comment, even if it's just making fun of me, I still appreciate you. All the engagement that I had in the YouTube comments and stuff like that was super rewarding. And then lastly, obviously, like, shout out to the Wolfpack, people that actually like spent money supporting me through the Patreon and joined the Patreon. It's been a really, really cool ride. I love that community a lot. You know, about, I think it's probably still about 200 something people in there. And you know, I'm a big fan of everyone in there. I, you know, made a lot of friendships through there, met a lot of people, built a really, really cool community, which I'm proud of. With respect to that Discord, I'm going to shut off the payment, but I'm still going to keep it open for people that are already in there as people that, like, you know, basically just grandfathered in. I'll still hop in there and, you know, give my thoughts on fantasy football, but more as like a casual fan than as like an analyst or anything like that. And then I'm going to keep the crypto chat open. The people want to talk crypto with me in there. I'm not going to open up the invite and make it a free Discord for everyone. It's just going to be whoever has paid at this point to be in it now is going to stay in it, and I'm just going to lock it down and then just keep talking to people. And then, you know, if you guys feel free, if you guys want to dip out or whatever, that's totally cool too. You know, if crypto is not for you, or if I'm not giving you enough fancy content now that I'm kind of retired, that's totally fine too. But just want to say thank you to each and every one of you that ever joined the Patreon. That was a huge moment for me. It was just really cool to see that community come together there. So that's what's gonna be happening there. I'll still be on Twitter. I'm still gonna be very, very active on Twitter, shit posting. You know, also probably, you know, half my Twitter posts will probably still be about football, because I'm still gonna be playing a couple of leagues, but I'm just not gonna be putting out like regular analysis anymore. I'm definitely not gonna be wasting any time getting into Twitter debates about who's the wide receiver one, who's the wide receiver two, because frankly, I just don't care anymore. So I'm just totally reallocating my time. I think, you know, Nick gave me some really, really good advice. You know, he said, look, like he's been through the ringer a couple times, obviously, and he's found like that sometimes, you know, he doesn't have that same drive to make fantasy football content anymore, but he loves like making vlogs. He loves making stuff like that. So I don't know if my love for like content creation total has died down. Like maybe at some point I'll make some content on like NFTs or, you know, just about random life shit or just being a degen, which I am. You know, some of you guys have seen my like degen Twitter threads or, you know, how I got to where I am Twitter threads. Maybe I'll do some more videos about that and I'll bring that back over to the Bunk Bed Breakdowns video. Thankfully, the Bunk Bed Breakdowns channel does not really, the title doesn't really say football, scream football in it. So I could really talk about anything. I could break down anything. I could break down NFTs. I could break down crypto. I could break down anything. So maybe at some point I'll upload videos there, but it definitely won't be any of this, any more of the regular like weekly stuff. You know, I might hop on there, talk a little bit about football, talk a little about NFTs here and there, but at least for the immediate future, I'm definitely taking a break from content, all content creation in the near to short term. I think I will be doing one last video though for the BDG channel because I set up a interview with Matt Harmon, the creator of Reception Perception, wide receiver film guru, someone who I respect a ton, and I've been wanting to get on a show with him like forever now. Finally, we found a time that works. That's gonna be coming in late April. That'll be my last video for the Big Dog channel. We'll probably go through a lot of, it'll still be obviously fantasy football related and all that stuff, but we'll go through a lot of content there. So I'm really, really pumped about that interview. What a great way to kind of end things off on, end off on a really high note, talking to someone of such a high caliber like Matt Harmon. So I'm super, super pumped about that. But that will be my last fantasy football content video that I will be making for Big Dogs, at least for the foreseeable future, while I kind of step back and you know, immerse myself more in NFTs and the other aspects of my life. But yeah, I just want to come on here and give you guys a little update on where I'm at. And like I said, hopefully you guys continue to crush it, continue to enjoy the channel. I mean, Nick, Noah, Max, and Snacks, they're going to keep pumping out great content. I'm sure they'll find someone else that's, you know, way better than me and come in and take over more Dynasty content as well. But, you know, I just want to say I'm leaving you guys in good hands. I'm still going to be watching the videos like I've always done. I've always watched Nick's videos on the BDGE channel. So I'll be a big supporter. I'm a lifetime supporter of Big Dogs. You know, I've been there for a long time as a fan, then a content creator, you know, then a part of a team and all that stuff. So, you know, I'm Big Dogs, live or die till I, you know, till I die, I guess. But for now, this is where I kind of step out of the frame. Let other people kind of do their thing and take over and take a little bit of a step back. You know, I think I had a good run. I don't even know how many episodes of Market Watch Mondays I've done. At some point, I'll probably go back and count it, but it's got to be in like the 100 plus, right? Like it's been at least 3 years, you know, 52 weeks a year. I never missed a single episode. It's got to be like 150 or something like that. So that, you know, I'm proud of. And, you know, more than anything, I'm thankful to Nick. I'm thankful to Big Dogs. Got nothing but love for the BDG team. Got nothing but love for the BDG fans. Got nothing but love for Wolfpack and Wolfpack fans. Got nothing but love for this space. It has given me a ton of opportunity. I had a ton of fun doing it. And, you know, it's sad to go, but at the same time, you know, it's time for something new. So, you know, stay tuned. Maybe, you know, subscribe to the Bunk Dead Breakdown channel. Maybe one day I'll post up some NFT stuff in there. Nick was gracious enough to let me do whatever I wanted with that channel. So, you know, I'll see if I come back to content creation. But at least in the near to short term, that's it for me, man. And you'll see me on Twitter still. You know, feel free to hop in my DMs. Feel free to ask some questions. But again, just ask some questions as a fan of the game, which is, I guess, what I always was. I never really considered myself an analyst per se because I didn't really know that much. I was just a guy who was addicted to the game, another degenerate gambler who's playing fantasy football. So I'm just going to go back to that. Go right back to being a degen on Twitter. Go right back to shitposting, which is my forte. So hopefully you guys find me there. Hopefully you guys still enjoy engaging with me on Twitter. I know I definitely enjoy engaging with the fans. But, you know, at least for now, adios from the fantasy football game. Thank you, thank you, thank you for all the support that you've shown me so far. I appreciate it more than any of you will ever know. It has truly been a tremendous ride. And lastly, yeah, thank you to Nick and the entire BDG fam. You know, my partner Noah, who we started the Bunk Bed Breakdowns with. Shout out to all the new members, Noah and Snacks and Animal and Steve, the MVP behind the scenes. Honestly, man, it's been an awesome, awesome ride. and wouldn't have it any other way. There's nothing, not a single thing I regret while I was doing in the fantasy football space. So leaving the space with no regrets, leaving on top or on bottom, I don't know, however you want to rank me, it doesn't matter. But yeah, I think that's all for me for now. And I guess until the end of April, until next time when I interview Matt Harmon, this is me signing off, and I'll see y'all on the interwebs.
I had a little goodie bag to give each and every one of y'all. We're using these whistles.
It was at this moment that he knew he fucked up.